Today marks a rather dark anniversary for one local murder case. It was 10 years ago on this date, a Massachusetts teen was murdered and left in a shallow grave in New Hampshire. It created a mystery for investigators and a tragic end for one family. Sean McDonald was one of the reporters who worked on what was known as the Hooksett bone story. He sat down with the victim's family 10 years later.
We always went to New Hampshire to vacation. We used to camp up in the White Mountains in the Kangamanx Highway. She loved it there.
14-year-old Kelly Hancock was part of many Bay State families who vacation in the Granite State. This would also be the place where nearly a decade ago, Kelly's murder would ultimately be solved.
When they told me, I just kind of dropped to my knees and tears came to my eyes.
Mark and Jackie are Kelly Hancock's father and stepmother.
I still to this day look for her when I go to Malden.
Kelly was one of six kids growing up in Malden, Massachusetts. She was also a known runaway. In fact, Kelly was on the run July 18th, 2000, when she was stabbed to death at a local condo building by this man, Thomas Krause. It's a moment her father is haunted by.
And all I could know is that she was crying out for me every bit of the way, and to this day, it kills me, you know.
Krause set the crime scene on fire and drove from Malden to New Hampshire with his girlfriend and her two young girls. Kelly's body was stuffed in back. Once alone, Krause buried the body on this secluded road in Hooksett. 9 months later, police were called here when the skeleton of a young girl was found.
It sits in a secluded area.
For almost 2 months, we covered this story as an unknown missing person, until Kelly's remains were finally identified, finally linked to that crime scene in Malden. The man police had suspected all along, Thomas Krause, was charged and later convicted of murder.
I think he should rot from the inside out. And that's being nice.
It's unclear how Kelly met Krause that day 10 years ago, but what happened continues to haunt the family.
When all that happened, I stopped everything. I kind of secluded them to the house. I didn't let them enjoy hanging with their friends. I just didn't know what road to turn, because I didn't want to lose nobody else.
At the time of her murder, Kelly was in the care of state DSS, but had run away from her social worker. Family says despite promises to improve the system, nothing ever happened.
She was a risk at running, and they knew that, and she did not protect her as far as I'm concerned.
A spokesperson for the agency says they couldn't comment on a case that dates back that far. As for Kelly Hancock, she is now under the watchful eye of her family. Her gravesite is just blocks from their Massachusetts home.
As a footnote, the murderer in this case, Thomas Krause, was convicted again from behind bars for a rape in 1990. We have much more on this story and this young girl on our website. I'm Sean McDonald, WMUR News 9.